So, it's been a while. It's been a long while since I've done a live stream. I did some Red Dead Redemption 2 live streams, but that was on career mode. Or campaign or story mode. Really. Doing career mode on UFC. Not a big UFC kick at the moment. About to select my first fight in the career. Figured I'd go with Shogun. I usually like picking existing fighters rather than creating them. I've got a few favorite ones, but I like picking existing fighters. And I want Shogun. So about to skip to my first camp. Like I said, just started the career mode. What I like to do, in all honesty, is I like to turn the punching power down for CPU and player, so the fights last a little longer. I want the boxer game, obviously, so I'm still doing it. I want to start working on the boxing right away. So I'm gonna just burn through a lot of these training things pretty game quick, because I've played career mode a bunch of times. And I'll turn the audio down a little bit. That's a little better. There we go. I'm also gonna adjust. There. That's a little better. Okay. Alright, now we should be good to go. Let's do this, burn through this training. I'm probably not going to do too many learning of punches at the moment. I'm going to see what's up, what I might be able to get here. Superman punch level 2, that might be worth going ahead and picking up real quick. Hook level 2. Yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and do this one real quick, and probably the other first one real quick. I said I wasn't gonna do much learning, and punch first thing I'm gonna end up doing.
Land at a high percentage. Great job! Push yourself! Excellent work! Great accuracy!
One of my favorite combos is to hit a jab and then a lead hook right after the jab. Pretty good quick combo. And then follow it up with an uppercut sometimes. If you got a guy that's got, you know, that advanced of a combo striker. Level 2 hook right off the bat. Oh, where was the other one? Not sure. Lead spinning back fist. Is that R2 and triangle, huh? That's a nice tight elbow there. I like it. I think I got a perk too, didn't I? Yes, I do. Okay, I like that. Alright, I'm gonna go ahead and learn that other. That's weird. That was really weird. That guy was all twisted. We'll go ahead and learn that other move, I guess. Why not? That Superman punch.
Work on your punch accuracy. Land at a high percentage. Beautiful speed. That's it. Precision. Come on now. Let's not get hit in there. We gotta keep moving. Use your feet to avoid the strikes. Nice combination. Let's pick it up a little and search for that knockdown. Pinpoint. really touched him up out there.
Didn't miss a punch. climbers. Body jab level 3. Then we got that Superman. And that is what? L1 and R1, okay. Okay, a couple more little training deals and we should be ready for the first fight. Oh, I got 20. And I gotta train my dude. Train his ass off. Alright, if we want accuracy and strikes, then, of course we're gonna lose some on footwork. That usually happens. Looking for power. There we go. Strike speed and power. I like it. Got to train that a couple times. Maybe we'll try to squeak one more out. Alright, we're going to go back up here. Head movement, stamina, and footwork. And I lose one on blocking at figures. Oh well. That's the give and take of training. Got 1 week left. I'm at 83% fitness. I'm thinking if I'm gonna have enough to be at peak fitness if I just train outright, or if I should go ahead and spar. I'm just gonna go ahead and train. If even if I'm not at peak fitness, I should still do pretty damn good. Of course, I'm gonna get some more wear and tear. Minor injuries, no big deal. The wear and tear sucks. I'm gonna go ahead and work on some wrestling and stuff to get away from the striking, so I don't get too much wear and tear there. I just gotta get some more of that speed and that power though. Just too tempting not to go for it. I'm at moderate fitness, and I lost more on my minor injuries. Oh well. Again, that's gonna happen. It's not like I can't whip this guy anyways. Like I said, I took the striking power for both computer and the player down, so the fights last longer. Hopefully see the fights go into some deep water. Especially since my striking power is not going to be up to a very high level either. This should go a pretty long time. I'm gonna get a drink real quick. Alright, let's do this shit. Let's go fight. These early fights are kind of boring. Thank you. you didn't like that Superman punch, did you? Damn, that's a blocking machine here. God damn. I might do some live stream playing some online fights. I don't know why my right-handed punch wasn't firing off at all. Of course, I don't got very good combo skills yet either. Oh, he walked right into that left hook. I didn't realize I had a head kick. I got head kicks on both sides. That's the thing about when you play is, ooh, he kicked me in the head. As an already created fighter. Oh, he kicked me again. They have some moves that you wouldn't expect them to have. Like some guys have the overhand right, just to, like Kimbo Slice. Play career mode as him and you already have an overhand right. I think it's like a level 2, maybe, to start off, which ain't bad. Seems like Shogun has head kicks. Ooh, and he ducked right into that one. Ooh! See, under normal circumstances, with the power set to normal, there'd probably already been a knockout. Yeah, it seems like you do the training and all that, learning moves, everything you gotta do to get to the fight, then if you just burn through the fight. I think that was my experience. I always seemed like the fights didn't last long enough. So once they put them sliders in, I was like, sweet, take the punching power down, make the fights last. Oh, there's a good head kick. Oh, yeah. Ooh. I should have thrown just a regular hook. I don't know what I was throwing spinning shit for. I don't even know what, honestly. I guess because it was on the Superman punch list. That's why I got the spinning punch. Normally, I don't do spinning stuff. So maybe a spinning elbow, but... I want to get that elbow in there. There it was. Up against the cage. I'm going to go ahead and go with a clinch. That up again. Oh, he don't want none of that. He knows I'm gonna put that knee on him. Oh, man. Get that tie clinch. Get that tie clinch. I got him destroyed. Oh, man. I wasn't even paying attention to the time. See, I don't really pay attention to the time because normally I have it ended by the first round, so. I do like how they added the sliders. Ooh, in career mode. Yeah, backed his ass right down. some elbows, bitch. Yeah. It's like these guys got Terminator chins. But I like it. I have noticed, though, as far as, like, the cuts and the bleeding and stuff kind of seems normal as far as, like, if the damage was set to normal. So it makes these guys look like they've been in wars. Oh! Iron Shin over here. Oh, he went low. Oh, he went low again. Go ahead and go low again. I'm gonna hit you with that uppercut. It's fun to just keep that pressure. Keep walking them down. You're gonna keep running to the right, I'll keep throwing them right hooks on you. Hey, now you're going to the left, I'm gonna hit you with that left hook. My left head kick. Oh! Okay. My turn. Try something again. Try something else. Oh, blocked it just in time. You might have got me. I don't know. Watch out. Gotta love that Superman. Ooh. I thought he was out of range for that kick. Go ahead, go that way. I'll just hit you with a right hook. Oh, nice knee. I haven't fucked with that tie clinch in a while. I think I need to hook that up. Oh, you ain't letting me get it. Here we go. Gotta get some elbows in there. Oh, I wanted to throw a couple uppercuts and then maybe a couple elbows, but he stopped me. Alright, elbow city. Oh, I went with uppercut again. I meant to go elbows. Me! Another round down. Alright, this is good. See? This is what I like. Three rounds of just like, straight up war. Ooh, thought I could trick him. Fire a couple low and then fire one high. Well, my best bet so my best bet so far has been that clinch. set up a few more elbows. Then go with a head kick, or a knee. There at that jab range, tear him up. You're gonna just eat some shit. If you wanna step in here, you're gonna eat a couple on the way in. Damn. I'm just not sneaking that head kick in on him anymore. Might be it. I hope he's gonna break. Or I'm gonna break, rather. He's gonna get out of it. I'm fighting southpaw now. Yeah, that's what I thought. Alright, see now, that's what I like. Good war. It's gonna be great once we start getting into the higher level fight. Championship on the line and stuff like that. He kicked me square in the face. I actually think I got the CPU's damage set up one tier higher than mine. Kinda makes me, you know, fight a little harder, fight from behind, you know? Fight one down. Pretty cool. Now you can do the sliders like that. Again, I'm gonna try to get through the training and all that bullshit as quick as possible. Get back to another fight. That's what we're here for, anyways, right? See, Shogun knocks some motherfuckers out. I was thinking Brian T. City Ortega, Rashad Evans, Ebby Nurse. God, I mean, I don't know how many fighters are on this game. Shit ton, and there's, out of those, a good maybe 15 or so that I'd like to run through a career mode with. Just, where do you find the time? Looks like I only got one fight to choose from, so it's going to make it very easy to pick which fight I go with. So, let's go ahead and go. I'm going to go to the same gym I was just at, so that'll be easy. Might switch up and go to a wrestler's gym next, but I doubt it, because I'm just going to keep working on boxing as it is. I'll just go up the top one there, just, you know, play it safe. I played a career's Chael Sonnen, and I was just shit-talking the whole career. I ain't in true Chael Sonnen fashion. Now I'm just going to go ahead and train. I ain't going to worry about learning anything. See how much... Already we started off with a minor injury. Just about to say, let's see how many injuries we can accumulate. Just gonna go straight down the list. As we get some wear and tear. Alright. Oh, we end on touch button the park. What a... Huh. I mean, come on, really? Is that really a... actual training thing, come on. They did, they put it in there. Box drills. Alright, I'm a glutton for the speed and power. I can just get as much of that out of my head as I can. And I'm not worried about promoting these fights, these lower level fights. I'm worried about getting as much attributes accumulated as possible in these early fights. I'm gonna go ahead and do two on this. But you know what? I'm gonna do one on it, and I'm gonna come up here and do accuracy too. There we go. And I really didn't take too much damage or, you know, injuries or wear and tear on that, so that's good. I should be at peak fitness. Oh no, I'm like 1 or 2% away from peak fitness. That is, oh well, it don't matter. I'm still gonna whip this dude too, like I whipped the last dude. A little bit, should be a little bit quicker maybe, because I'm a little bit, you know, stronger, got some more power, some more accuracy. Probably gonna work in that Muay Thai a little bit earlier. That'll start wearing them down a little quicker. I know I said I want the fights to last longer, but I'm also looking for ways to be efficient as well as make them longer.
Hey, I'm UFC President Dana White, and we're always looking for up-and-coming talent to sign. Back in the day, I used to scout the world looking for new talent, but I haven't done that in years. I'm looking for the next Ronda Rousey, the next Robbie Lawler,
I hear you.
The next Conor McGregor.
You.
I'm looking for future champions.
You look,
and I'm willing.
All you want.
It's gonna be a smoke
I'm
show.
Gonna go ahead and kick this motherfucker's ass.
Think
about maybe taking him down for some ground and pound.
These guys are scrappy, man.
Oh, nice.
He's abusing this guy.
I'm gonna work that tie clinch from the inside. Tear his ass up with some elbows. I gotta try to just get him off me. I don't have good transitions yet or anything. I did bust his nose up though.
Look how banged up this dude is.
Damn, stumbled in too far back. Oh, nice. Tell I got some more speed and power behind me. I just need to get them combos. Start learning the boxing combos and stuff like that. Muay Thai combos. Definitely the Muay Thai combos. Oops, I don't want over under. I want Thai punch. I want throwing them elbows. And then a knee. How'd that feel? I swear I just heard someone on one of the sides call out donkey kick. I swear I heard donkey kick. Huh. I'm a little tired, so. Just so. Oh man, I'm not too marked up really. It's mostly him. Most of the blood I got on me is his. Ooh. That might have marked me up a little bit. I'm trying to get that clinch and he just said, you know what? I might go ahead and give us punches to eat. Think about that for a little bit. He went for the clinch.
He's taking everything that dude is wrong with him tonight.
Here we go. Oh, he ducked into that uppercut.
Watch.
I'm just throwing uppercuts like a madman. Ooh, ooh. Now he's starting to, now he's starting to touch me a lot. I don't like that, buddy. You can stop hitting me any day now. I'm gonna go ahead and give you some of these elbows to think about. Next time you try to hit me, think about these elbows, buddy. I'm gonna leave you with this knee, too. Oh, he is messed up. What do I got going on? But I ain't too bad.
I'm telling you, he wins this fight, I can bring him in.
Oh, man, really? No replays or nothing.
Yep.
Oh, the classic bottom middle top kick. I didn't really mean to do it, but it happened. I was trying to hit him with a head kick the whole time. Oh, I hate them spinning back fist. Oh yeah, nice kick. Pop, 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 motherfucker! Ooh. Staying close on this guy, he's got the reach on me. I just need to hit this kind of clinch. Go ahead, duck for that takedown again. Hit you with that uppercut.
Look at this. Oh, look at this.
Now I will say it's not like I seen the takedown coming and timed the uppercut perfectly. It was me throwing an uppercut as he went for a takedown. So it's not like I actually meant to do it per se. I did mean to throw an uppercut. I just didn't see the takedown coming at the time I threw the uppercut. That was all just luck. Like right there, I was thinking uppercut. And I should have, because he was ducking low. I think I should look for a clinch again. Nice. Oh! What am I doing? Oh, I hit L1. Oh shit, I forgot.
Got a better chance of
I don't know what I'm doing.
Putting
now.
Us to sleep than each other.
Oh really, this ain't an exciting fight? Guy's gonna go out. It's gonna be just an extreme knockout like the last fight. Big ass hooks and he's gonna go down. Oh, there it was. I'll get that clinch one more time before the round's over. There we go. Hit some elbows. Oh, not the over-under. Right to a full tie clinch. Knee. Man.
I ain't making fun of him now.
Holy crap. Bumble's got him out of there. He's taking a lot of shots, though. He can't take much more of it. Took that shot just to throw the one of my own. Time to just start throwing these, Jab cross combos. Left, right, left, right, left, right. I mean, he's a taller fighter. He's got a little bit more reach on me, but he's got him wore down. You know what I forgot about? I have a front kick, too. Ooh. I don't have like a flying knee. No, I don't have any flying knees yet. Now I can destroy this guy. That's gotta be it. Oh, he's getting back up. He lost some more. They're saying this is the worst fight ever? I don't know, man. I don't know what they constitute as a good fight. Oh, the front kick. I mean, damn. He's just banging the whole time, and it's a bad fight. And now they're saying, wow. Oh, God. Inconsistencies over there. Bop. Nice Superman punch. Boom, and followed by a nice hook. Oh, look at that. Wham, we're both kicking each other. And instead of going for my clinch that I wanted, I'm juking. Hitting the wrong buttons. I thought that was a good fight.
That kid has a lot of talent and a lot of potential.
We're
gonna
do this. What you were just saying.
We're gonna give him a shot in the UFC.
Yeah, if that guy makes it, what you? Of course, that's your first rival. What time is it? Okay. My next victim has been picked. I'm just gonna go ahead and stay with the boxing gym as well. Told you I'm coming for you. Just signed a contract. Whatever. Burning through it. Like I said, there ain't too much I want to, I mean, obviously, there ain't too much from here at this point I want to learn. I want to keep Shogun as mostly a striker. And, really, he's already got his hooks up and stuff, so until I get higher level hooks, which I don't have access to unlocking those yet, once I get those and a few other little odds and ends, different training facilities unlocked to get different skills learned, or moves learned rather, I'll go ahead and do that. But for the most part, I'm just going to train the shit out of this guy and get him up to high stats right off the bat. Maybe by this next fight, I should have easily an 80 on speed, 75 on power. Maybe 75 on power. My accuracy too should be up there too, because I'm not worried about promoting these early fights either, really. Not until I start getting higher up the ranks. Accuracy is going to be at 80, so I'm actually going to go ahead and bump it up again to 81. That's going to help my strike stamina too as well. I go down to box drills, power, speed, and endurance. Let's just see how far we can go. Yeah, 81, and would be 75 if I had one more chance. But oh well, it's all good. We're good there. Once I get enough money to unlock a different gem, or you know, whatever I gotta do there to learn different strikes, I'll go ahead and do that too. But right now I'm in no hurry. I'm just building up them stats.
Megan O'Leary, and this is your UFC Minute. The UFC returns this weekend with a fresh face who is destined to make headlines. When UFC President Dana White went looking for a fight, he was hoping that he would end up with a future UFC star. And those are the expectations after he signed a regional champion who has dominated the local light heavyweight circuit en route to his octagon debut this weekend. That's it for today. Stay tuned for your next UFC Minute, and I'll see you.
Coming up next, it's a UFC light heavyweight division encounter.
I think it's going to be him entering first, or is it me?
No, well, it was me.
Okay.
We'll
go ahead and watch his entrance, see what they say about him.
That night, as such, here he is, making his UFC debut a few short months later, and the question beckons. Will there be jitters? We hear a lot about those UFC
nerves. I like reading this part right here. Because as you progress through your career, it'll change different things there, you know, with what it says. Pretty cool.
Lights of the famed octagon, there's no denying the skill set, the skills, the demeanor. That's what got him to the big show. We'll see if he can perform now in the UFC.
This guy is an excellent striker. What he wants to do here is avoid grappling exchanges, utilize his outstanding...
All right, let's do this.
You ready? We are underway. All right, here
oh,
we
he
go.
Didn't want to touch gloves. He just wants to start duking it.
UFC debut. He won his fight on Dana White looking for a fight, and Dana gave him the UFC contract. And this is a legitimate challenge here. No easy outs in this division. We'll see how it goes for him here in his first UFC start. Oh, he's feeling it now. Nice combination there by Shogun Rua.
The elbow already cut him up.
Oh,
I hit him with the second one, digging it in.
The opening seconds of this fight.
Oh, how good is that jab?
1-2. Good defense there.
Oh, that hook has been there all night. There's another one by Hua.
Oh, big knee!
Overuse boy.
There, and he has shown an increased vulnerability to that strike, Joe, by leaning
have to
in
reach on him, so I'm just going
to
try
to set up his own offense. We'll see if he lowers that guard.
Keep mowing him down with punches
to prevent further damage.
Excellent job of landing punches here. Look at that, he's timing that jab.
How about that shin?
He's doing a very good job of parrying and blocking all the shots that are coming towards his head.
And that left hook landed on the button.
Keeping his block broken down.
And he is staying committed to that jab. Oh, clipped him with the jab.
He lands a clean combination.
Oh, he blocked that offense, Joe.
Very good exchanges here. Clips him with that uppercut.
He had nowhere to go. He just had to sit there and eat uppercut.
He tagged again.
You really want a tie clinch?
He gets the Muay Thai clinch. Nice big knee! Big knee!
Oh, he might be out. Big shot!
He's got him hurt here. And he's checking every single one of those.
Well, how about this approach here tonight? Technical striker, and he has gone mad. Very accurate, but really just an all-out aggressive approach that we haven't seen from him in the past.
He's keeping busy here, connecting with a lot of punches. Nice hook there. There's another one.
Who is lower jaw now, Joe, started to show some signs of swelling.
Nice body shot.
Try to establish that jab.
Oh, nice.
Under 2 minutes in round one. So he's able to land another punch there. Nice work on the feet tonight by Hu. Left-right combo is good.
Yeah, he's getting lit up here. Caught him with a punch.
Oh, he lands another strike to the body, really starting to connect on a lot of shots to the midsection, and these will take their toll as this fight goes into the latter rounds.
Very good job of timing these punches.
Oh, roundhouse kick lands. Nice lead hook by Hu. Working on a single leg here. And busy as he looks to improve position here.
Side control.
Oh, right hand is there for him, Joe.
He's getting off some very nice grounded pound here.
No, oh, he's not even going to stop it.
Good right hand.
And how much more can he take?
That was it.
Wow.
That was beast of his ass.
Wow.
He shouldn't even have went for that takedown.
Got the full mount, secured the position, and dropped bombs.
How about the ground and pound to finish the fight, Joe? That is as good an offensive execution as we have seen on the ground in recent memory. One big shot after the next. He wasn't just trying to score or buy time before the referee stood them up. He was trying to pound his opponent out of there, and that is exactly what he did. You wonder if some fighters will watch this footage and learn from that high-level offensive execution.
I think he was trying some kind of a arm trap or something, maybe. Because he had his arms out. But I just said, you know what? Arm trap me, motherfucker. I'm just going to keep throwing these hooks. Didn't work for him very well. Might be able to afford another. Either a kickboxer or a boxer gym. I had a chance to fight this guy, I believe, last time, too. We're all 3 weeks out, so... 4-2, 5-3, 5-4. I'll go with this guy, I guess, because I had a chance to fight him last time, so we'll go ahead and fight him now. Schedule my camp. Not enough cash to unlock it.
They don't care for us. They just leave us on the block.
Kind of figures. Now I'm just going to stick with where I'm at then. It hasn't done me wrong. Not yet, at least. I just ignore the haters. They keep watching. I'll be a dick about it. Yeah. Now I'm probably going to have to spar here. I'm sure I'm going to accrue some wear and tear and minor injuries as usual. But whatever. I'm not worried about peak fitness, actually. What I'm more worried about is them stats. Probably gonna mess up some wear and tear on me, but that's okay. Do these. I'll go ahead and do... Yellow trunks. Okay. I'll probably get to the first rivalry fight and fight that, sign the next contract for the next rivalry fight that'll be coming up, basically. And I'll probably end it. I might do another fight after that. I don't know. It all depends. What time we got? Oh, it's 2 o'clock in the morning already. Well. Yeah, I'll probably be done after that first rivalry fight.
So the decorated Muay Thai practitioner.
See if it says anything different now that I've had a fight.
So many different ways to end this fight early tonight.
Say something about fast hands
kicks,
or something.
Beautiful
working
knees,
on my speed pretty good.
Punches in bunches, elbows in the clinch. He'll go to that elbow early and often. Got to be mindful of that tonight. And any one of those weapons are fight enders. If you've watched the film, you know that. Good to see this man making the walk to the octagon tonight.
This guy is an excellent striker. What he wants to do here is avoid grappling exchanges, utilize his outstanding striking skills, and keep this fight from becoming a ground fight.
Let's do with his long old hair. Let's do it.
All right, ready for live action here at the MGM Grand Garden Arena here in the fight capital of the world. So after a win by knockout in his UFC debut, here he is making the walk yet again. We'll see if he can move to 2-0 in the UFC, and that could set him up for a potential contender-type fight. This is a guy who is all the rage with fight fans right now, given what he did in the debut, and now you got to think he'll certainly have even more confidence as he makes the walk here tonight.
He connected with another uppercut. He's landed a few big ones so far here.
No doubt about it, Joe. With conviction to the body.
Good job landing the series of strikes here.
They're just trading body kicks.
Wow!
Oh, big left hook there.
Beautiful jab. Vicious combinations.
And he connects there.
Oh, the left leg goes high. Nice left hand.
Oh, that's bleeding bad.
Oh, Superman punch. Not always easy to execute. He did so there.
Really didn't want to try that.
And completes a single leg takedown.
Oh, elbow up top by Shogun Rua. Elbow's landing now.
He's getting beat up a bit with elbows here. These are absolutely
gonna end the
vicious
fight.
Elbows.
Shogun gets up. Clearly, he wanted this fight back to its feet despite having a dominant position on the ground. Oh, man, defensively leaving a lot to be desired there. He moved right into that hook. His head was wide open and there for the taking. Let's see if he can make some adjustments here moving forward.
He's doing a great job blocking these shots.
Nice punch by Hua. Gets the elbow up into the target. And that one certainly found the target.
That one hurt.
Oh, and he connects with yet another hook. Nice job on the feet by Shogun Rua.
His uppercut is dialed in.
I know it, right? I mean, who said it, Rogan?
Strong defense here as the hook to the head is blocked. Oh, beautiful jab there by Rua. Well, no issue finding his timing here. Nice series of strikes.
He just keeps circling to the left.
Got caught with a left hook there.
His right.
And he lands the roundhouse.
But he's circling to my left. I'm like, fuck it, if you're gonna keep circling that way, I'm gonna hit you with that hook.
Oh, ooh. He missed that kick.
He stopped circling left for
really
just that little bit.
On the defensive here early, very aggressive right out of the chute. He has landed a high number of total strikes. Exactly the aggression you'd like to see, given what is at stake here tonight.
Tagged him.
I mean, the hand speed, just absurd.
Here we go.
Shogun gets double underhooks.
Oh! Big knee! He's hurt!
Oh, he might be out.
Big punches.
He's got him hurt here. Oh, big left.
Nasty combinations here. He just whips that punch in.
Switching stances here. Hits the elbow there. Rua gets caught with that punch. Don't be afraid to get that head off the center line. And he's got him up against the cage. Rua gets the tie clinch here.
Oh! He's in big trouble.
Oh!
Might be able to get a first round knockout here.
Oh, very nice. What an exchange here.
Oh, the Superman punch is there, Joe. You can tell he's been working on it.
Beautiful hook.
Left his head wide open to absorb that straight hand. He has shown a vulnerability here by leaning in right into his opponent's range.
Good shot.
How about that chin?
It appears the cut on his cheek is getting worse.
Whichever way he's circling, I'm going to go ahead and throw the hook that way.
He continues to find his timing here. A series of strikes, they all land.
Him. They look two hooks in a row.
Rua gets touched by that kick to
the
body.
Same side.
Tag to the hook. There's another one.
Good defense here, Joe, as the hook to the head is blocked.
You gotta be careful when you throw the same technique over and over and over again.
Oh, he gets tagged again. Nice combination. Lands to the body. Try to establish that jab. Oh, he just continues to pour it on. He has been aggressive all night long with his striking. Got to be careful here to not empty the gas tank. So far, so good, though, in this round. Red horn sounds mean we have reached the end of round one.
I'm looking forward to the replay of this.
And here's a nice punch that lands clean.
Damn, nice Superman.
Let's and here's another punch.
Oh, they're gonna show that Superman. Oh, that was a different one. Ooh, with the left hook follow up.
And here's another perfectly placed punch.
Man, all
punch.
Supermans? Really? Wow.
Some real clean striking on display in that round.
The lovely Brittany Palmer getting the round one assignment.
Okay, you ready? Round two. Ready?
All right, round two. You gonna touch him? Yeah, he's touching gloves.
Starting off this round, you gotta think he's probably still hurt from that last round. He's gonna want to move and avoid taking damage early.
Well, he hasn't really showed any signs of slowing down tonight. He continues to connect on a high volume of strikes here. That landed.
Oh!
Double jab there by Shogun Rua. Both fighters throwing heat now.
His right eye is swelling really bad.
And he gets tagged. Nice combination, Joe.
Really good job of landing that series of punches.
That one connected.
Right hook.
another punch to the head by Rua. Landing a good series of strikes here. Big power shot there. Oh, and he lands another leg kick there. There is nothing fun about being on the receiving end of that, I can assure you. And now let's see if this slows his opponent's movement down a little bit.
Body kick, look at that. Checked.
Able to land to the body there with the left kick.
He's picking him apart. Oh, very nice. He is going after it here.
Well, again, Joe, he leaves the head wide open and eats the hook shot there. I know he's got a good chin, but you got to think he'd be wise at this point in time to get back to his defensive principles. Move that head, get on the tip of his toes, move those feet. Yet again, they will clinch here.
Get him.
He transitions elbow to the tie clinch.
And lands an elbow on the inside.
Big knee! Big knee!
He's got him hurt here. Oh, straight right.
Big shot.
And now he lands a combination. The left hook hits home. He pummels. Now he's got double up. Oh. That one appeared to stun him.
He's getting tagged.
Hey. Oh, he nailed him. Oh, he gets back up, but barely. Look how wobbly he is.
He's in a lot of trouble.
Oh, big left hook there. Punch is blocked. Hook to the head lands flush there by Shogun Rua. So a much different approach for him here in this second round. He was a little bit tentative in round one, a little bit of a feeling out process. Now he has clearly found his rhythm, found the range. We'll see if he can continue with more activity here in round two.
And lands a good shot.
He's got him hurt here.
He's in a lot of trouble.
Lands a nice 1-2.
Oh, he's going for it here. Oh,
wow! Gets up again here, but hurt. Goes down again.
This fight is dangerously close to being stopped.
That's how you do it.
Beat him up. A huge roundhouse kick for the knockout.
Oh, absolutely one for the highlight reel right there. A tremendous kick to spell the end of the night.
Like I set the damage all the way. The punching damage for the player all the way down, and I put it two clicks up. I went all the way down to the lowest possible setting and went two clicks up.
Outstanding performance.
And then I went.
We
one
can see it from a
or two clicks
here.
Above
Look
that for the computer.
Power
so the computer's actually got more punching power
when
than
it
I
lands,
do.
The fight is done. Look at this. Bang.
And I set both of our stamina sliders
so
down
there he is
for
as
CPU
the
and
computer. A huge
our end player.
Tonight. That
so that way we can actually throw more punches without
the
gassing ourselves out. Which I might turn that back up a little bit more, so we gas a little bit, so. Because I'm starting to swarm them. And now that I got that swarm and shit figured out, I can just swarm the shit out of them. Now I'm putting them out in two rounds. So, that's cool though. I like seeing how good I can progress like that, and then move the sliders one way or another to compensate for it, to keep the fights kind of going long. I have a feeling if I bust off a submission in the next fight, I'll get a fight of the night. Yeah, it was a good kick. Block! On the dome. Oh, there's two more fights. Three more fights. This one, the next one, and then the rivalry fight. So I don't even think I'm going to make it to the rivalry fight. I might even only do just this one. Maybe one more after. I don't know. I'm getting a little tired. We're all low. We're all 4 weeks. So we got 5-1, 6-2, and 6-3. I want to fight the 5-1 because he's only got one loss. What the hell? But then again, look at his stats. They're lower than shit. Everybody's a little bit lower. I'm just a beast. Alright. Upcoming fight, or special camp, rather. Of course, the opponent's gonna be out of there. And I ain't got enough cash to unlock any other gym, so I'm gonna just have to go to this. I'll go to the jiu-jitsu gym. And I'm gonna learn me a submission to go ahead and put this guy out in a submission way. What the hell, why not, right? Oops. Upcoming fight. That's what I wanted to do. Ooh, hey, well, I got Muay Thai combos in there, so I do like that. Still going on with that, Bulldog choke, sweeps, and all in Levar. So I'm probably just going to do these two. Throw 5, 3 straight combos, and hold rubber guard. Okay.
Alright, let's step this up now. I want to see 3 strike combinations. Strike more! Not it! You gotta throw more strikes or he's gonna see that kick coming. Mix it up! You got more! Telegraphing those kicks.
Oh, I see. I know what I gotta do. I was like, what is going on?
Come on! More strikes! That's the way we land kicks. Keep them off balance with those combos.
I was like beating them up with them 3-punch combos, but I didn't realize it was a kick too. Duh. Okay. Because it's Muay Thai combos, so that makes sense. Apply moves, kicks. Jeez Louise. Lead by the crane kick. Okay, I like it. Combos. So I got kickboxing 2, Muay Thai 2, and traditional level 2 now. Nice. Punches and elbows deal more damage than the guy. I like it. It's gonna be hard to do this one. Hold the rubber guard. I hate these ones. In all honesty, I do hate these.
Let's get better at that rubber guard.
Decisions. He's gotta wait for it to pop up, and I flipped the wrong way, so I'm gonna go ahead and restart it because I already done failed. So let's try it again.
Hold this rubber guard, make him suffer.
And you don't have to be like immediate with it. That's what I keep fucking up, is I try to flick right away and I flip the wrong way. I just give it a second to see. Might be able to. Oh, right.
You fight like that, you're gonna dominate.
Okay, so we got a lot of perks there. Fly moves. Takedowns. Outside trick. place the go-go plata. And the omoplata. And now perk. Improve fighter's ability to get to feet, improve transition speeds and any guard position, improve finishing submissions when on bottom. We'll go with all the level 3s and a level 2 level 2s and 3 level 3s. I'm all perked up now. How many weeks do I got yet? 3 more. I'm just gonna go ahead and train them out now. Gotta find the, there we go. Kind of far real quick.
Work for that Goga Plata. That's it. Work for that submission.
Oh, I didn't mean to hit try again. What did I do that for? Damn.
Good work. Nice block.
Okay, just as bad as it was before. Man, if I'm looking for a submission, I'm gonna put this guy out quick. Man, I'm in the UFC minute a lot.
Hey everyone, I'm Megan O'Leary, and here's what you need to know for your UFC minute. It came as a shock to the MMA community when this fighter left his longtime gym recently. But that's
All right, coming up next, it's a UFC light heavyweight division collision.
Division collision. I would have liked to have put Shogun in the middleweight division, but I swear you used to be able to put him in any division you wanted.
So
whenever you pick
an existing
fighter, you could put him in any division you wanted. I thought. I'm pretty sure I had Bruce Lee as a heavyweight at one point. And now I don't think you can do that, or at least I don't know how. I don't know.
Gotta be mindful of that tonight. And any one of those weapons are fight enders. If you've watched the film, you know that. Good to see this man making the walk to the octagon tonight.
This guy is a great striker. What he wants to do is land hard and early, get the respect of his opponent, and avoid any grappling.
Yeah, I don't want to avoid any grappling, really, because I can do that, too. This guy's about to find that out.
Well, Joe, you can even sense the history just walking into the venue tonight. Good to have you with us as we get underway from the world-famous Saitama Super Arena in Saitama, Japan. All right, ready to go for round one, and this young man's popularity absolutely soared on the strength of what he did his last time out. It was a win by flush knockout, kept his winning streak intact with style points, and now the challenges get decidedly more tougher. We'll see if he can keep the momentum going in what is unquestionably the biggest spot of his UFC career. And busy as he looks to improve position here.
He's posturing up here. It appears that cut is getting worse. Excellent movement and transitions here on the ground. Staying busy.
Nice punch by Hua.
His opponent's got his back.
Effective strike there by Hua.
Now it moves into full guard. And he gets reversed. Slides him over, and nice reversal here. And he's back in the guard. Back in the mount. This is crazy.
Looks like he's trying for a submission now.
He's got the leg up. Looks like he's got this go-go Plata locked up tight. That's a deep choke.
Shit.
Lean forward, pulling on the head. And he got free. That was close. Excellent movement on the ground here. Always trying to better his position. In half guard.
And he connects with the punch there. Hua gets up. He is back on the feet here.
He's fainting with the punch.
Oh, uppercut lands, and he leans right into that one, Joe. Left the head wide open there for the taking. Let's see if now that wakes him up a little bit, and he learns to get those hands up.
Excellent job of timing these combinations.
I thought it was over.
Hua gets caught with that.
Couldn't finish the go-go Prada.
Perfect combination.
Doesn't mean I didn't do damage, bro. He's hurting.
Good exchanges from both fighters.
Shogun gets tagged by a solid uppercut there. Nice jab, follows it up with a nice right hand. Oh, he has mastered the range here, timing his shots nicely.
That was a nice jab.
And try to further expose what surfaced tonight as an obvious weakness.
And he's in the Muay Thai clinch.
Another elbow from the clinch lands. Joe, huge block there. The defense is holding up.
Oh, elbow to the head.
Nice knee to the body there by Hua.
Again. Oh, big knee. He's hurt.
Oh, he might be out.
Oh, he hurt him. What a wild exchange.
The left hook hits home.
Hard uppercut to the head. He is really finding his range with that uppercut. He's teeing off with some vicious shots. Oh!
Clipped him with the right hand there.
That cut on his cheek is really starting to get nasty. They could stop this fight.
How about that shin?
That one hurt.
Good combination of jabs for him there.
Very nice shots landed.
Really finding the range now. Good series of kicks. Those are all landing, Joe.
He's fainting with that punch, showing that punch.
Well, still plenty of time to go here in round one, but what a start for this man tonight. Aggressive to a fault.
Oh, big knee! He's in big, big trouble. Landing some shots. Oh, head kicks.
Oh, big left hook there. Superman punch now.
Oh, he's going for it here. Nice right hook.
Back and forth we go here. Oh, beautifully placed with the hook there by Hua. And he landed the right hand there.
Oh, he caught him with an uppercut.
Big power shots landing. Oh, Superman punch. Well, he's connecting with his punches now. Took him a while to find the range. He has found it now. Works out for the end of round one.
Damn. That was a fight. Oops. I want to watch the replay. Crap.
Second round here.
Now starting off this round, he might still be hurt. He's going to want to look to be defensive and move and avoid getting hit and try to recover.
Well, he hasn't really showed any signs of slowing down tonight. He continues to connect on a high volume of strikes here. Mixes it up nicely in terms of staying heavy and also staying active. Well, so here's a decorated striker who at times, Joe Rogan, has been exposed on the ground in the grappling realm when it comes to his Brazilian jiu-jitsu defense. We're not expecting wholesale changes when it comes to his submission offense tonight, but he has left his longtime striking gym and moved to a Brazilian jiu-jitsu camp, training alongside and underneath some of the most decorated Brazilian jiu-jitsu black belts in the world. You gotta think he'll be much more confident if this fight hits the canvas here tonight. Well, would you look at the total strikes landed there on the graphic at the bottom of your screen? We've been talking about his pace and his activity and the volume all night long. Few fighters are going to be able to keep up with this pace. He has landed one punch after the next here all night long.
Absolutely.
And he lands a nice kick.
Oh, man.
So unguarded right into the pocket.
Uppercut
as
city.
Such, he leans right into that uppercut, left the head wide open. And I'm not sure how many more of those, Joe, he's going to be able to take. Let's see if he gets the hands up, tries to circle out, and get that head off the center. Lua's lower jaw very swollen now. Time to bite down on the mouthpiece and move forward.
Wow! Oh! This could be it right here.
Come on, get up.
Back to the feet.
This fight is dangerously close to being stopped.
I want some more. I want some more.
Oh, Superman punch. You can tell he's worked on that,
this
Joe.
This could be it. These are some bombs he is throwing. Big Superman punch.
Oh, and he lands yet another punch. That can't feel good. You can see he continues to target that cut on his opponent's eye. Oh!
Front kick to the face.
He's got him hurt here.
He's in a lot of trouble.
I can't believe this guy's still in it.
He connected with another uppercut. He's landed a few big ones so far here.
Absolutely, Joe. That uppercut is fire. Kick lands. Oh, how about the output for this fighter here? A lot of good time shots there, and they're all landing.
Oh, we got tagged.
Hand speed, man.
He got lit up.
Oh, Superman punch lands.
Oh, man. Get up. Ooh, I missed him.
Well, he's really picked up the pace here in round two. Yeah. Much more aggressive. That one appeared to stun him.
He is hurt. Big shots.
Oh, I want to get that knockout. Oh, yeah.
Establish that jab once again. Rua gets caught with that punch. He'd be wise to get those hands up, Joe. Over under hooks here. Boy, top right. He's got him hurt here.
Oh, he nailed him. Oh, that one dropped him. Oh, man.
He's going to keep beasting him with that Superman. Times you're gonna rock him.
Oh! He's getting tagged. Oh, he got caught. He's hurt badly. He's down. Oh, he tagged him. Oh, he's out. He's out.
He's out. Here is the big uppercut that led to the knockout. He had been throwing that uppercut throughout the fight, but this last one was the one that led to the KO.
Yeah, Joe, I'm not sure if that's the way he threw it up, but a huge result for him here tonight as he gets the win by way of knockout.
Can't say that wasn't fun, that wasn't
a one strike finish as we've seen here in the UFC in recent memory. I'm not even sure the opponent saw it coming, so a big, big win for him here tonight. Let's take a look at that again. Check out this angle here. Boom! Perfectly placed uppercut.
The official decision is
that was a lot of fun. 12 knockdowns I got. 17 stuns and wobbles. Dude, I beasted him. last fight for the night. Break him down with some strikes. And I think I'm going to work in that submission, that Gogo Plata that I learned. I'm going to work it in for you. Get a bit of a beating him up first.
This man has put together one of the best knockout streaks this division has ever seen. His goal tonight is to extend it in the biggest fight of his life. Landing a good series of strikes here, punches in bunches. All right, so here we go with round one, and you got to be mindful of those overhand punches if you're his opponent. You know it's a big part of his game plan. Every time out, it's his go-to punch. We'll see if he can find a home for it here tonight.
He's got good accuracy on that jab. He's feinting with the punch.
Lands flush with the left hand.
He's doing a fantastic job of blocking shots.
Connects with the punch there. Well, he's always on the counter attack, but a nice leg kick there by Hua.
That was a very quick combination.
Well, he got his head snapped back by that straight hand there, and he's shown a vulnerability tonight by leaning right into that punch as he tries to set up his own offense. He may want to focus on some defense here moving forward.
Nice shot. Oh, landed it. Look at that straight right.
Checks the leg kick.
Oh, the uppercut is clean. That big uppercut. Really threw a lot of power into that uppercut, but missed.
And a knee.
They're trading blows here. What an exchange. He is going after it here.
Ooh, blocks the shot.
Big shots.
The left hook hits home. Whoa!
He is getting off some huge punches here.
Kick lands forward there. Hua's facial cut is getting worse now, Joe. Man, is that thing fauceting blood.
Blocking all the shots coming towards his head.
And he lands a nice kick. Well, you gotta like the way he has started this fight tonight. He has come out aggressively, connecting on a lot of shots here in this first round. No doubt, a crowd-pleasing approach from him here tonight. Oh, that's a big block, Joe.
All of those are blocked. He's keeping his head protected here. Excellent blocking. He's looking for that elbow. Inside leg kick. Good punch.
Oh, how about the multiple strikes landing here? That is a serious offensive barrage.
Look at that, right to the temple.
Just over 2 minutes to go.
Goes for a single. He grabs a single.
It's over with.
And he's going for the choke now.
He's got the leg up. That choke looks locked up tight. That choke is deep. Lean forward, pulling on the head.
That's it. He went to sleep. Sleep, motherfucker.
He got choked, didn't tap in time, and went out.
Yeah, Joe, I'm not sure if I'm most impressed with the setup or ultimately the technique to finish off the choke there, but his opponent showing off his patented toughness wasn't willing to... We go inside the octagon. Bruce Buffer has the official.
They hated Esco. GG.
They hated Escobar. I'm still here. AB's talk that talk. Streets need that. NYC, LA, Chicago, Detroit, the whole world. Let's get it.
Now I had a basic plan, get out the projects and never look back. Could still smell the aroma from when my uncle was. But
Oh man, almost 3 o'clock in the morning. It's time for me to go to bed. I'm gonna get my next fight set up. The rivalry fight. It'll be a good way to start the next game off tomorrow. Probably do another stream tomorrow. I'm gonna schedule my camp. Kickboxing Academy. Alright, well, that's gonna do that for tonight. And I will continue this career at some point. Hopefully tomorrow. Hopefully it won't take me too long to get back at doing some live streams.